On, it's your boy BT, and I came here to talk some boxing with the thousands of True School Sports subscribers. Now, word to my brethren over there down at the University of Miami, they just put a beat down on Notre Dame, 9-0. As a kid from South Florida, good to see the U turning things back around. But post-fight review, the official post-fight review, this is what it is, the official post-fight review for Daniel Jacobs versus Luis Arias. Daniel Jacobs scores a easy 12-round decision over Luis Arias, and this fight to me, as I said earlier this week, if you're a guy like Jacobs, you've proven that you can hang on the world stage, you can hang with the best middleweights in the world, and you're fighting a guy in Arias who's relatively untested. You know, to go from Arias to go from a guy like Magomedov, who was a front-running prospect, to go to a world-level contender in Daniel Jacobs, big step up for him. He talked a lot in the press conference and in the pre-fight build-up. It was very entertaining, but when push came to shove, you know, what we saw in there was a guy that was untested, nervous, and at this stage in his career, very much out of his element. Now, it wasn't for lack of effort. I think Arias, you know, he gave the best effort he could, but he was in there with a better fighter, a more experienced fighter, a more professional fighter, and a more talented fighter. So it was a fight where, you know, Arias would come forward, and you know, he was throwing these really looping right hands that were missing, and he was out of his element. There's really no other way better to say it than he was out of his element. Jacobs was out fighting him on the inside, out fighting on the outside, showing on different looks. Luis Arias got beat in every aspect of this fight, and there really aren't too many positives to take from this performance from Luis Arias. So, you know, tough night at the office. You know, that it was that first true step for him in his career, and obviously it didn't go as he planned. But he's a good fighter. You know, he's got good talent. Obviously, for me, I like Luis Arias. I think he's a good fighter. But one thing I always had a problem with him is that he holds his hands way too close to his face. I think he, you know, not, I don't know if he's gonna change that. That's who he is. But I've never been a fan of guys, unless you're like a Mike Tyson or someone with really quick feet, you know, holding your hands real close to your face like Luis Arias. You know, when you're fighting a guy who throws them short punches, a guy that knows how to punch from different angles, like a Daniel Jacobs, a seasoned pro, good amateur, you know, world title challenger, you know, the guy will take advantage of that. And you know, it's back to the drawing board for Arias. So, you know, congrats on a good effort, but he was out of his element tonight. As for Jacobs, you know, good performance from him. You know, Daniel Jacobs was a guy who came in tonight, a heavy favorite, in my opinion. You know, he was fighting a guy that was untested, like I said, a guy that was out of his element. And he made him look like that. I thought Daniel did a great job staying mentally disciplined for 12 rounds, you know, working the jab, showing him different looks out of the southpaw stance. You know, there was a couple of times in the fight where they got in close and on the inside, and Daniel bullied him on the inside. So the talk in the pre-fight press conference was, "Daniel, don't run when I hit you." And ultimately, it was Arias doing more of the running than Jacobs. And I thought overall, if you're looking for a complete, if you would like to me, I thought what we saw tonight might have been Daniel Jacobs' most complete performance. And he might just be in that stage of his career where he's coming into this to his own. You know, a loss is not always a bad thing, and I think this could be a good example. You know, Jacobs, since the Golovkin fight, the loss has actually seemed done him well. He seems to believe more in himself, and he seems to have gone to the gym and gotten better at certain aspects of his game. So, what's next for Jacobs? You know, he said in the post-fight interview that he will be going to Montreal to call out the winner of Lemieux Steve Lemieux Saunders. So I'd like to see that. I think that if you're looking for if you're Jacobs and you're looking for a direct path to a Canelo or a Golovkin fight, then that's the way to go. You fight one of those guys, you beat them, you snatch up a title, and then all of a sudden you're right there again. So, you know, for me personally, I want Lemieux to win that fight because I'm a big fan of Lemieux. I think he's very entertaining to watch, and I like to see Jacobs Lemieux because I think that would make for a great fight, with Jacobs ultimately winning. But overall, man, cool night of boxing. You know, there was the fights on ESPN too, as ESPN as well. You know, you had Jose Ramirez get a stoppage over Mike Reed that apparently was questionable. I'm gonna have to go back and watch that. And then Amir Young Master Imam returned to the ring with a sensational performance against I forgot the guy's name, but sensational performance against Gar I think guy, last guy guy's last name was Garcia. pretty much pieced the dude up with just a jab and looked really, really good. But obviously, he's gonna have to step it up next year when he gets his big title fight against Jose Ramirez in February. But that'll be another video for another day. This for Daniel Jacobs. He gets the 12-round decision, completely outclasses and dominates the untested prospect stepping up in Luis Arias. So let me know what you guys thought about. Let me know what you guys think about his performance and all that good stuff. And yeah, leave your comments down below. Take the time to subscribe, and you can love me or you can hate me, but I'm just a kid from Daniel. So until next time, take care, guys.